Hello and welcome to Manna from Devon Cooking School in South Devon. I'm David Jones and today we're going to be making a really simple recipe, hummus with garlic and lemon. Hummus, I'm sure you've come across hummus at some point or other, absolute staple in the supermarkets, but fantastic to make yourself, nice and sort of fresh and with some great zingy flavours in there. It's a dish from the sort of Eastern Mediterranean and the Middle East, so you'll find it in Greece, Turkey, Lebanon, Syria, everywhere across there. And on a platter, you will find some hummus for sure. And basically, hummus is a paste of chickpea, and it'll often have some sesame seed in there or some sesame paste, some tahini. The one that we're making today doesn't have any sesame paste in it. We're just going to have lots of fresh garlic and lemon. So just have a look here at what I've got ready for this. Chickpeas, one tin of, and we're gonna whiz these up. So a tin of chickpeas is absolutely fine. Salt and pepper, garlic, and we're going to use one nice sort of fat clove of garlic in there. Everything is of course to taste, so if you really like it garlicky, and that's going to make it pretty garlicky, but you could go even more if you wanted to. And then we're going to take the zest of a lemon and the juice of a lemon a little bit later on as well, and we've just got a little bit of coriander there to sprinkle over the top to provide a bit of colour. We're going to start off with a little bit of sunflower oil, which is a fairly neutral taste. It's not going to sort of overwhelm anything. And I'll probably just finish off the dressing of it with a little bit of this very nice olive oil, just as a little drizzle over the top. I've got a little bit of water on standby if I need to make this a little bit thinner without adding any more flavour. So it's a very simple dish. You can make this in a pestle and mortar. You can just grind it up yourself. That will be absolutely fine. But I'm not. I'm going to use the faithful mixer. Hooray! And they're going to mostly go in there, except I want to just keep a few as a little decoration later on. So, chickpeas in there. Little half a tablespoon of sunflower oil. That's going to be for later. And pita breads, that's what we're going to eat it with. We'll keep those for later. We need some garlic. So let's do that. And we want to sort of either mash this down a little bit or chop this up a little bit before it goes in the mixer. Otherwise it won't distribute terribly well. So we're just going to chop this down a little bit. Just to start things off. That's going to be quite a lot of garlic. It's not going to be cooked or anything, so that garlic is sort of exactly as you're going to taste it. So that's going to pack quite a punch. And then we want the zest of this lemon with this nifty little zester I've got here, which takes it off in these lovely strips. Now I'm going to keep a few of these strips for decoration, and the rest can go straight in. See that, how it just removes the whole lot. And that's where, you know, you just get this fantastic lemon oil. The flavour from that is outstanding. Anybody who takes the juice out of a lemon and throws away the zest is mad, because, you know, put this in soup, put it in a casserole, put it in stew, put it in dressing. You know, there's all sorts of things you can use this zest for. So to throw it in the compost bucket, madness. So there we go. This is a nifty little. That's a nifty little tool. So keep a little bit for decoration, and in goes the rest. Found a bit more garlic. Ooh. In it goes. Let's have a nice squeeze of lemon. Not the whole lemon. I wouldn't start with the whole lemon because that would make it really sharp. But of course, it's entirely up to you. But let's start off with that and see how it goes. Nice pinch of salt. And a little pinch of pepper. Splash of water. And we're ready to whiz that up. And I'm just going to give it a pulse, scrape it down, give it a pulse, scrape it down. And you can leave this quite chunky. If you buy it in the supermarket, it will always be totally blended to a smooth paste, because that means that the antioxidant, the preservatives that's added to it, will distribute nicely through the hummus completely. So it doesn't tend to have much in the way of texture. But if you get a freshly made hummus, it may have more or less texture. And if you like it really nice and chunky, go for it chunky. If you want to blend it really smooth, a little splash more water and keep blending. See how that just pushes up the side, so I do need to just keep scraping that down once or every now and again, every minute or so. It's only going to take us a few minutes to blend that up. So you kind of think when you're doing this, it's almost easier to do it in the pestle and mortar. By the time you faffed around with all this scraping down. And hey, we buy all these expensive pieces of equipment, we've got to use them. It is, of course, easier if you're making a huge amount. Just a little bit like this, and tends to stick somewhat up the sides. So at this point I can also start to taste it, and I'll know if I need, you know, a little splash more lemon juice, maybe a bit more salt. Have I got enough garlic in there? That'll stand a little more lemon. So that can go in, and that's also a little bit dry. So the lemon's going to help with that. We might also have another splash of water. But only a splash, otherwise all of a sudden it's too sloppy. Suddenly that's looking more like it. Now we're starting to look the part. We just have a little looky in here. Come and have a look. That's starting to sort of look more like it. I still think that looks just a tiny bit dry, so I'm going to have another taste. And it's either going to be another splash of lemon juice or another splash of water, depending on on how it's tasting. Certainly not going to hurt to have another splash of lemon juice. That is tasting good now. Oh, yes. And I just, you think, you know, I don't mind supermarket hummus. I think it's one of those products, actually, that it's easy to process. You don't need to add an awful lot of stuff to it at all to make decent hummus. So I don't mind it, but you just don't get the freshness of flavour and the real kind of zing to it that you get from making your own. And it's not exactly difficult. One final blast. And now it's just a question of how smooth or not you like it. And that, with just a little bit of texture left in it, is absolutely fine to me. So I'm going to stop at that point. So here we are, ready to scoop that out. Into the bowl. Beautiful. So you could have this, you know, just with some little chips of some sort, or some pita bread slices, nice glass of something chilled, nice glass of cold beer or relaxing, very Greek would be a kind of ouzo or a raki or something of an early evening, with a little bit of hummus and a few olives. Fantastic. Let's just smooth that out a little bit. And just for presentation purposes, here's the rest of our chickpeas. Lets people know what they're getting into and adds a bit more texture. And then some more, or that the lemon zest on top of there. Let's have a little sprinkle of coriander. Just like that, around the edge. And if you're going to serve it just like that, just before you serve it, then I would go with just a little drizzle of a really nice olive oil. And that is our tahini, our hummus without tahini, our hummus with garlic and lemon, really nice and zingy, quite healthy, of course. Some nice beans, pulses, very healthy. Little splash of oil, nothing too crazy. And apart from that, what's not to like? So, that's wonderful. And what we can also do with that, if we want it to be something a little bit more substantial, is to make a nice little pita pocket and fill it through full of hummus and salad and tomato. So I'm going to do that right now. So in front of me now, we've got the hummus, of course, some nice little tomatoes, nice and ripe, red onion, a little bit of a mixed salad, sort of baby leaf salad there, and a little bit of a lemony dressing. And I've got some pita breads here. And I made these pita breads using the simple, versatile Mediterranean bread dough, which you'll find on this channel and on the website, mannafromdevon.com. So you should be able to knock those up, or of course you might have bought your pita breads. And hopefully, if we've made these as we expect, then this is going to open up into a nice pocket, ready for us to stuff. Whew, that's a relief. So there we are. Lovely. And this is now going to be a really healthy kind of a snack. We've got our nutritious hummus, lots of lovely chickpeas, a little bit of salad, tomato, onion, you know, nothing in there to worry about. Let's just chop these onions up, these tomatoes up a little bit. A little handful of those. And then some very finely sliced red onion. And we're pretty much ready to go. So I open up my pocket, some hummus in there, and sort of spread it around a little bit. Little salad. In that goes, along with a little handful of tomatoes, a few little shards of red onion. And repeat. Let's put a tiny bit of hummus there so that we know what we're talking about. There's one. Just have to be careful opening these up, but I kept them wrapped up in a cloth. That's kept them nice and soft. They've sort of steamed and stayed beautifully soft, so you know I can handle them without fear of them splitting too much. So some hummus in the bottom. In goes some salad. In goes some tomatoes. Shards of onion. Salad. Tomatoes, onion, and a final little bit of hummus on the top there. And there we have some rather splendid looking homemade pita breads with homemade hummus and salad. The recipe, if you want it, you'll find on our website, mannafromdevon.com. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you again.